Good evening. This round is a choose your own adventure quiz about my two favourite things, music festivals and the past. Now, I'm going to pose you all a series of festival dilemmas with three possible courses of action for each one. Choose right, you get a point and a positive outcome for the team of Graham. Choose wrong and humiliation awaits, mainly mine. So, as I've said at many a festival, grab your tablets and let the adventure begin. With you and your friends uncertain how to kickstart your weekend, your group leader, Charlie Cotterill, a.k.a. Party Chaz, that's Party Chaz, proposes three different ways of taking this puppy to the next level. However, only one of these is an alcoholic cocktail. The other two have a more sinister air. Without enough phone signal to check anything on Urban Dictionary, which of the three do you choose? The Green Dream, the Mudslide, and the Crazy Horse. Which one of these is a lovely alcoholic cocktail to be enjoyed at Glastonbury in June 2009? Catherine.
I have written Mudslide, and I believe it's made of vodka and chocolate.
There's no need for showboating at this early stage in a supposedly hard quiz. Desiree.
I have also chosen the Mudslide because I believe I took a bartending course for a month in which I learned which bottles are best to throw over someone's head if they're attacking you. Wow. And I remember the Mudslide. The other two sound like they're laced.
One of my specific conditions was no people who've done a bartending course. Richard.
Condition fulfilled. Because I've put the Crazy Horse.
Merely for variety's sake, Richard, that's fantastic news. Mm. Although, having heard Catherine literally say what the ingredients of a Mudslide are,
yes!
You've got to feel you haven't scored a point.
I do feel that, yes. Who'd take chocolate to a festival?
Richard, you chose the Crazy Horse. You watched Friday's headliner, Neil Young and Crazy Horse, accompanied by the horse tranquilizer ketamine. I'm afraid to say your K-hole is captured by the BBC live feed and you're unable to escape the nickname Gurning Graham for the rest of your time at university. You've had a shocker. However, Catherine Ryan, who literally knows what this is, and Desiree Birch, who's attended a violent bartending course, are both correct. You slammed down your Mudslide in just three goes, and then you cap it off by doing an actual Mudslide through a waterlogged field. You get free showers for the rest of the weekend, and you're on the front page of The Guardian. It's worked out well. It's a point to Catherine and a point to Desiree.
Yeah, I know.
Question two is about, of course, vegan food.
I'm out.
After an attempt to sleep off slash live down your antics of the first night, your Saturday gets off to a great start when you get chatting to a management consultant with a top knot at the Jazz World stage and learn that he's John Berkow's nephew. Soon enough, one thing's led to another, and you've offered to shout him a falafel wrap. Barnaby is palpably moved by the gesture, but does stress that it needs to be vegan. What is the safest order? Falafel wrap with sujuk. Falafel wrap with labneh. Falafel wrap with frika. Mm. Catherine.
I don't eat any of that. So I've guessed, Ivo, with labneh.
Right. Desiree, what have you guessed with?
I am lactose intolerant. I always have to be on the lookout for dairy. I think labneh is a yogurt, so I think no.
Fuck!
Sujuk, I'm not sure, but I feel like I've seen frika, on like a vegan menu, so I went with frika.
Who the hell are these two ringers?
Yeah, unbelievable. Sorry, Richard. Desiree really is bringing a hefty amount of personal experience to the quiz. Richard, what have you gone for?
I went for frika. Because I thought someone making things up wouldn't use three E's in such a short word.
Desiree, you were absolutely right, which means that it is a point for Desiree and for Richard because you've both gone for frika.
Yes.
You're swollen with superfoods and soon Barnaby is inviting you to the Berkow's house in the south of France. So it's all coming up birch as we head to question three. The Healing Fields. Ooh. Glastonbury, as we've all read on a henna tattoo, is about much more than just the music. So with just one day left until you have to take down your tent slash strip the beds in your yurt, you head to the legendary Healing Fields to broaden your horizons. The question is, which of these is an actual healing process? Kabaddi, Ayurveda, or sounding? Catherine, okay. What have you put?
Ivo, I've put sounding. Because
interesting.
I think there's a gong and it's meant to call all your energies into the right place. Sort of like a dog whistle, but less sinister.
Right. Desiree, what have you put?
Now, I've put Ayurveda. Ayurveda? I don't know, but it's written on a lot of the spas that you go to.
Really?
So I'm assuming that Ayurveda is a healing process. I don't know what Kabaddi is. I think sounding's a kink thing.
Richard. Which of the three options did you go for?
I didn't put sounding because I thought it was a kink thing.
Right.
I could be wrong. I think it's a kink thing.
I just put it because it was so banal. Why would someone make it up? That was my reasoning.
Right. Well, none of you went for Kabaddi. It's an extremely energetic and occasionally violent game, largely played in South Asia. However, that would still have been far preferable to the option selected by Catherine and Richard of sounding.
Oh, dear.
Urethral sounding is the horrific process of a metal rod being inserted into your appendage for pleasure reasons. It's a private members club that nobody wants to be a part of.
What? The king thing. Is the sound just the thing you make with your own mouth?
What?
Luckily, you don't have to find that out because you realise what's about to happen just in time and you flee the tent. However, you are haunted in your nightmares by what you describe forever as the glint of the rod. Desiree, you went for Ayurveda. Well done, or should I say wellness done?
Yes.
Ayurveda is the Sanskrit word for life and longevity, and you will spend the rest of your life and longevity telling people about the herbal tincture you got at Glastonbury, even though you paid £20 for some Calpol. And this last question, a double pointer, is not so much about wellness treatments and kinks, it's about the networking that I've really been wanting to do at Glastonbury this whole time. Which is why question four is about meeting David Cameron.
Oh, my God.
Just a short hour before the headlining performance from the freshly reunited Blur, you're hanging out at a cheese bar selling the wares of the band's bassist-turned-farmer, Alex James. Mm. Over a thick slice of the finest Stilton to ever come out of the Cotswolds, you look up to see none other than James's friend and neighbour and leader of the opposition, David Cameron. You know there is only one way to impress David Cameron with your own political awareness. It's by making a quip about the recent MP's expenses scandal. However, you have to pitch your quip right. Which one of these was not an expense claimed by one of David's Conservative colleagues? A floating duck island, 500 trees, or two pornographic films? Which was not a Conservative expense? Catherine, what did you go for?
I've gone with trees, not MPs. Sort of, you know, hugs, not drugs.
It's less an answer, more a slogan.
Yeah.
Desiree.
I am in full agreement with Catherine. I feel like every other day, like, the Conservatives are getting done for something pervy. So I feel like the pornographic films, for sure. Duck Island, they probably want to shoot them. So 500 trees seems like they wouldn't have expensed that.
Richard. What have you gone for?
500 trees, only because it seems like a relatively legitimate expense.
Yeah.
You've all failed,
no!
I'm afraid.
Oh, shut the fridge.
However, if you'd said two adult films, you'd have hit the jackpot, or should I say the Jackie pot. MP Jackie Smith, Labour's Home Secretary, claimed two blue movies because her husband watched them at home while she was away. You make a joke about this, you say the only blue movies I enjoy are your campaign videos, and Cameron turns the purest shade of gammon you've ever seen. Fast forward 2 hours, and you're singing along to Blur together during the encore.
Ivo, is that a photo of you sounding?
No, I'm not being sounded at that specific moment.
Very painful.
So none of you chose that, so I'm afraid you've all missed out on the 2-point bonus. Your weekend is over. Your only hope now is that you can spin your personal shame into a slightly laboured quiz format for a comedy-focused digital channel. Tonight, Richard got just 1 point, Catherine got just 1 point, and the runaway winner practically from the beginning, the woman of the world, Desiree Birch, has had a cracking weekend at Glastonbury in my 18-year-old shoes with 3 points.
Wow.